I think if you'd have given Arsenal fans a choice in the summer of Lacazette and Aubameyang, they would have, most of them would have plumped for Aubameyang.
Well, because he's a better striker.
Well, the problem is, they've got Lacazette. He's been there 12 months.
They're panicking.
But Arsenal, by the way, Arsenal are not struggling because of Lacazette.
No, no, there's many areas that they need to...
He's way down the list.
But having someone like Aubameyang come in, would that not just create a spark amongst the squad to get things going a little bit, get a little bit of excitement around the stadium as well, which is so
Yes, it may, but I'll tell you what's not going to help when you sit Lacazette on his backside when you're bringing Aubameyang in for him.
Arsenal are a bit...
So the positive thing's getting a negative thrown at it straight away, which is why I ended up saying, OK, so you're looking at Mkhitaryan. It's been horrible the last 18 months.
Arsenal are a bit like Chelsea at the moment, and we're going to talk about them later on. I really don't know what direction they're going. I don't know which... It's like the red arrows flying everywhere. I mean, I just don't know. It's like, right, Sanchez is going, Ozil might be staying, so we might be getting Mkhitaryan in, and we brought that Lacazette in the summer, but Aubameyang's available because Dortmund are not happy. They're looking for a fee from him. These two London clubs at the moment... just look as if they're lacking direction. I mean, we've got one manager that's stubborn and wants to stay. We've got another manager in Chelsea that clearly wants to go. And meanwhile, United are splashing the cash, Liverpool are splashing the cash, City are splashing the cash, and they're all pretty sure what way they're trying to go. But Arsenal, along with Chelsea, and we're talking about Arsenal at the moment, it's almost like fighting fires every transfer window to try and appease the fans. See, Wenger said, we told you we'd spend some of that money we've got. We told you we'd match the big boys. That's what it seems like. But if they do get Mkhitaryan and Aubameyang in, then I think that softens the blow somewhat if Sanchez's deal goes through to Man United.